Hi, in this video what I want to do is I want to cover knife sharpening. Now it's not something I claim to be an expert of, and there are lots and lots of people out there far better at me than knife sharpening. But I was sent some water stones from worldofsurvival.com, and I'd already bought a set. I'd had a set, here's my set, about 3 years ago I had a set from him. But it inspired me to think, well, hang on, I'll do a video review on water stones. Now, I was on looking through YouTube, and I saw a video by West Carter Cutlery. Sorry if I got your name, company name wrong, but it's like that, West Carter Cutlery. And he had this big water tub, and he had this contraption on top, which held his water stone in place. And I looked at the idea on video on YouTube. I looked around at trying to purchase one, and I thought, do you know what, I can make one. And what I've done is, okay, it's from an old pallet, so it's two blocks on the end and two short stops on the top, okay, and they just fit over your regular size washing up bowl. Now what this enables me to do is with my water stones, is obviously soak them in the water first. And ideally they want to be soaking in there for about 10 minutes or so. So we're just going to presume the time has elapsed. But it then holds my water stone in place on this board. It's not going to move around nowhere. The beauty is, with water stones, you need to keep keeping them wet. And then my water is right over where I'm working. So I can keep putting the water straight on top of it, and it also raises my water stone off my workbench, so I've got room for the handle on either side of the stone. So I'm going to put that back in the water, let that soak for a few minutes. So this is something I'd recommend you all making if you're going to use water stones. And then what I'll do in a few minutes, we'll come back once these have soaked, and then I'll talk about using water stones with both a Scandi grind, which is like a flat ground blade, and with a convex edge. Okay, see you in a few minutes. Right, now we've had our water stone soaking in the water for about 10 minutes. You need to actually saturate these stones. On the stones, these are a combination stone. So on the top you have a 1000 grit, and on the bottom you have a 6000 grit. Okay, the white or the yellowy stone, creamy stone, is a 6000 grit. So what we're going to do, we're just going to start. This little blade here, this is like my little, what we call a cub knife. It's a little Scandi grind. Again, it's my own specification. It's a little flat ground, Scandi ground blade that I use for sort of like carving and whittling and just really small utility tasks. So to do a flat ground blade, place the blade on the stone flat, and then you just tilt the front until the tip is actually flush with the stone. If you're new to this and you're not 100% sure, hold it so the blade is facing you, and then tilt the blade until you can't see any daylight, okay, until the black line disappears on the edge, and then you pull the blade towards yourself and out. Okay, if I do it this way, I'm trying to see so you'll see. So you push the blade and off the edge, okay, and the whole time moving forward. And regularly either wet the blade or wet the stone. And whatever you do to one side, you do to the other side to keep it even. And we've got a helper. This is Mouse. He's our new little Bengal kitten. All right, Mouse? Just put you down. So he's a new addition to our family. So, repeating the process, I'm just gonna... And it doesn't matter whether you push the blade away or pull a blade towards yourself, either left or right-handed. So just do what feels most comfortable for you. Right, I think we're... Now what I'm just feeling now, just feeling the edge, it's very, very sharp at the tip. But I've got a bit of a dull spot back here. Okay, up here I can really feel it on the ridges of my fingerprints. Back here, it's not quite so sharp. So we're going to concentrate on the back end a bit more. Just a little bit more down the bottom here. And something else you want to try and do is try and use the full width of your stone and try and use the full length. Gradually what will happen is it will wear away in the centre here and you'll have two higher points at the other end. But try and use as much of the stone as you can. Okay, we're pretty much there now. So we've basically reground this edge on both sides. It is pretty sharp. So now what we're going to do, put the stone back in the water, just wash off all the slurry, off all the black marks off the top, so you keep it nice and clean, ready for the next time you come to use it. And now what we're going to use, can use a 6000 grit, and this is basically going to put a polished edge back on our cutting profile. Now with these water stones, they come with a secondary stone called a Nagura stone, and when you're using the 6000 grit, you actually use this stone when they've both been soaking in the water. This has been in the water the whole time, and you create a slurry on the top. So just go around in circles, again using the whole width of your stone and the full length of it, and create a slurry on the top, because it's a slurry that actually does the cutting for you. and we repeat the process we did on the earlier part. So we're going to push off and slide up. And see this black line? It's more clear on this side than it's on the other side. That's actually the metal. We're actually shaving very, very fine piece of metal, and that's the polishing. And what I like to do with the tips of my knives, as I said, I don't claim to be professional at this or an expert at this. I can normally get this part of the blade down here very, very sharp. Sometimes I struggle on the tip. So some of the strokes I do will actually be starting from the tip and then working to the base of the blade. So I'm actually concentrating on the tip to get the tip as sharp as the back end. And I'll do some with the other hand, just in case it's easier for you to see. And then what I like to do, just to finish these blades off, what I find, if I use them on the water stones, I don't need to use a leather strop. It's not necessary. And all I like to do is just using the end grain on this wood that I've got here, it's just very, very lightly, using less than the weight of the blade, just run it along there, okay? Just like that. And what that'll do, that'll just take off any little burrs that might be on the edge. Okay, so we know this blade is sharp. So that's doing a flat Scandi grind. Now, you've seen, you haven't seen this particular blade actually. This is it's my SFK. But then what I've had made, as I said, I've had the cub made and they're now paired up on a different sheath, okay? It's a very slightly different version to the one you'll have seen on the videos. Basically the same design, okay? This one has a convex edge. Now when doing a convex edge on a flat stone, we need to do a slightly different technique. So we get the stone back out of the water. We're gonna go back onto the 6000. And what we need to do is again, we place the edge on and we tilt it just until that daylight goes, okay? And instead of pushing it in straight away, we do circular motions, but I'm gonna try and exaggerate it slightly, but we also tip the blade back and forward, okay, up and down, as well as round and round. And it's a technique that will take a little bit of getting used to. But what we're looking to do is obviously keep on a Scandi grind, obviously the cutting profiles are dead flat. On a convex edge, it's slightly curved. So we're trying to replicate that rocking motion, that curved edge, while sharpening. here. So we're going to keep the circular motion going, and we're just rocking the blade. Okay, same as before, just going to put it through, you can see that. That was me drawing the knife. I'm going to try and do it, pushing it through. It's wet there. Okay, so that's how to sharpen a convex edge and a Scandi or a flat ground edge on a Japanese waterstone. And as I said, the stones I'm using are King Waterstones, and they come as a pair, and they're from worldofsurvival.com. You can find them on eBay, or he has his own website. Okay, thanks guys.